From this, we can take a microscopic explanation to see what each of these different states of matter have in common and what they have different from one another. We're going to say that for the gases, remember, they assume the shape and volume of their containers. We can see that in the third container, it's kind of like a pink haze inside of the container. That's because if you give a gas a chance, it will take up every single inch of space that's available. So it'll take on the full shape and fill up the entire volume of any container it's in. For the liquid, we're going to say it assumes the shape of the portion of its container it occupies. So in the middle container, we can see that the liquid becomes a cylinder just like the container it's in. It takes on the same shape of it. But if there's not enough liquid, it can't take up the volume. So liquids usually just take up the shape, but not necessarily the volume. If there's not enough liquid to fill up the entire container, then it won't take up the volume. Solids, we're going to say, maintain a fixed shape and volume. Now, for the next category, we're talking about compressibility. All this means is, am I able to squeeze the atoms to make them more tightly packed, to bring them closer to one another? So remember, compressibility just means, am I able to squeeze the atoms within each of these states of matter? Here, the gases, the molecules are very far apart. The atoms, they're super far apart. They're bouncing everywhere. Because they're far apart, I'm able to squeeze them and cause them to become closer together. So we're going to say gases are very compressible. I'm able to use pressure, increase the pressure, and squeeze them closer together. In liquids, the liquids are not as tightly packed as solids, but they really are next to each other. They're sliding against each other, sliding around each other. We're going to say that liquids are not easily compressible. We can barely do anything to put them closer together. Solids, we already said in the beginning that solids form a rigid structure. The atoms are tightly packed. They're as close as we can make them. We're going to say that solids are not compressible at all. Finally, the last concept, viscosity. Viscosity, just think of it as resistance to flow. Okay, so we're going to say viscosity is the resistance to flow. What does this mean? That just means that something that is viscous does not want to move. Let's think of two different examples. Let's say we have two buckets. We have a bucket of water and a bucket of honey. And let's say right in front of us is maybe someone we don't quite like. Maybe a childhood bully, maybe a classmate, maybe even a professor. If I took that container, that bucket of water, and I tipped it over on top of the head of the person, the water would fall onto them very quickly. Water moves very easily because water has a low viscosity. It doesn't have a big resistance to flow. It'll flow easily. Okay, so we say if you flow easily, you have a low viscosity. If we took that bucket of honey, though, and we tipped it over, we would say that honey is more viscous. Honey moves very slowly. It wouldn't be able to dump all of the contents onto the person's head. It would move very slowly. So if you move very slowly, you're viscous. So we're going to say that gases have a low viscosity. They move very easily. They're bouncing off the walls, bouncing everywhere. So gases have a low viscosity. Liquids would also have a low viscosity. The water we talked about, water flows easily. So we'd say that water has a low viscosity. Solids are kind of slow. So we're going to say solids have a high viscosity. They don't move. They don't move very easily. Now, for solids, how could we make them more viscous, less viscous, make them move faster? You can apply heat. We're going to say if you increase the temperature of a substance, then you excite the molecules in that substance, and then you decrease viscosity. Okay, so just remember that. Increasing temperature lowers viscosity. Increasing temperature makes you move faster. If you move faster, you're less viscous. Now, what we're going to do now, we've seen all the different types of explanations for the three states of matter, and we're going to pay very close attention to our gases. We're going to say that the gas is distinct from the liquids and the solids. And because it's so much more compressible, because it's more greatly affected by temperature and pressure than the other two, that's why we're going to pay so much more attention to the gases. We're going to pay attention to the gases and help us form the ideal gas law. That's what these sets of videos are going to be focused on. Just the ideal gas law, the different types of matter that exists, especially gas. So guys, just remember, when it comes to gases, they're very distinct from the other two. And because of that, we're going to pay very close attention to them and the effects that happen to them when we mess around with the pressure, mess around with the temperature, and play around with the volume.